This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, this is example 29 of equations with fractions, and not only are there fractions, there's also parentheses. So there's two ways of doing this. You can do the distributive property first, or you could eliminate the fractions first. Let's do it by distributing first. So we get negative 3 times x is negative 3x. And be careful here for the second one. You're doing negative 3 times a negative 2. That's going to be plus 6. All right, over here we've got 3 eighths times 14 minus 3 eighths x. Okay, now you can go ahead and cancel here, but the least common denominator is still going to be 8, so I'm going to suggest you go ahead and just leave that as it is. So I'm going to rewrite this as negative 3x plus 6 equals, and 3 times 14 is 42. So I'm going to write this as 42 eighths minus 3 eighths x. You could reduce, but then you're going to end up making it a little bit harder, actually. So I'm just leaving it in the unreduced form. All right, so now you look at it, and what's the least common denominator? It's easy because the denominators are the same. So the least common denominator is 8. So I'm going to multiply 8 times each term. 8 times the negative 3x plus 8 times 6 equals 8 times the 42 eighths. And this is what I was talking about. If you just leave it, that's going to be easy to cancel out the eighths. Okay? And 8 times the 3 eighths x. So on the left hand side, we don't have any fractions here. So we have 8 times negative 3x is negative 24x. 8 times 6 is 48. The 8's cancel here, so I just have 42. And the 8's cancel here as well, so I just have minus 3x. So now we're down to a problem without any fractions and without any parentheses. So let's just get the variables on one side and constants on the other. I think I'm going to put the variables on the right side, just so the coefficient of x is positive. So I'm going to add 24x. And that means that I'm going to have 21x on this side. So I also want to subtract 42 from both sides. So that gives you 6. Almost done. I need to know what x is, so I've got to divide by 21. And then I'm going to write down what that reduces to. If you divide 3, numerator and denominator by 3, I'm going to get 2/7. So in the end, I end up with x equals 2/7. I don't know if that's the right answer or not. Let's do it the other way, see if we get 2/7 as well. So this first method, what we did was we did the distributive property first, then we multiplied both sides by the least common multiple, and then we solved it. And we got 2/7. All right, we're going to solve this equation by eliminating the fraction in the first step. So there's only one denominator, and that's x. So let's multiply both sides by the least common denominator of 8. So on the left side, we'll multiply it by 8. Now it might be easier to think of that as negative 3 in parentheses, because you don't want to think of this as 8 minus 3. It's 8 times negative 3. And we're also going to multiply on the right-hand side by 8. So this will cancel on the right-hand side, okay? But on the left-hand side, we have 8 times negative 3, so we really have negative 24, and then we're going to multiply that by x minus 2. And on the right, we notice the 8's cancel, So we're going to end up with a 3 times 14 minus x. So now let's distribute carefully. We have negative 24 times x, which is negative 24x. And we have a negative times a positive here, so it's plus 48. And on the right side, we're distributing our 3. 3 times 14 is 42, minus 3 times x is 3x. Now, it doesn't matter which side of the equation you put the x's on, but I like to put it on the side that's positive. Just, I make less mistakes when I don't have a lot of negative numbers. So I'm going to add 24x to both sides. So that I'm going to have my variable on the right-hand side, so I want to subtract 42 from both sides. So that gives me, let's see, on this side, 48 minus 42 is x, I'm sorry, is 6. And what do I have over here? I've got a negative 3 and a plus 24. So the answer is going to be positive, because 24 is positive, and 24 minus 3 is 21, x. So then we could divide both sides by the coefficient of x. Don't divide by 6, divide by the 21. And that gives us, if we reduce 6 to 21st, we get 2 sevenths equals x. So we did get the same answer, eliminating the fraction in step 1. All right, now let's check our answer. So we've got to be careful here. We're just going to be doing order of operations. And to be honest, it's usually easier to do the problem over than to check your answer. So I've got to put in negative 2/7 for x. Now, instead of writing minus 2, I'm going to get a common denominator because I need to have the same denominator. So what would that be? 2 is the same as what divided by 7? 14. Or if you need to, 2 over 1 times 7 over 7 gives you 14/7. All right. Now we don't do the distributive property. We simplify inside parentheses. So that gives us, inside the parentheses, negative 16/7. So this gives us times negative 16/7. And nothing cancels there, so I'm going to just have to do negative 3 times negative 16, that's 48/7. All right, now let's do the right-hand side. We're putting in 2/7. So I'm going to have 7ths for the 14 as well, right, when I subtract that 2/7. So I have to, if I'm going to make the 7ths, same reasoning, I've got 14 over 1 times 7 over 7. And 14 times 7 is 98, so I'm going to get 98/7. So I've got to do inside parentheses first, that's order of operations. So we have 3/8 times, all right, so I've got 98 minus 2, that's 96/7. Now, instead of just multiplying across, let's cancel the 8 and the 96. All right, well, 8 goes into 96, actually, I think 12 times. That's not going to work out. So I'm going to look back and see if what I did wrong here. And I just noticed I put in a negative 2/7. Oops, did you notice that? I like to get it wrong once in a while so you can see that it's so easy to make mistakes. All right, so this is really going to be negative 12/7, right? 2 minus 14 is negative 12/7. So the left-hand side is 36/7. There we go. And over here, 8 goes into 96 12 times, so I get 36/7. All right. I was noticing that I was going to get 36/7 over here, and I got 48, and I thought, uh-oh, I must have done something wrong. So I always first see if I even plug the right number in, and that's the first thing I noticed. So be careful when you're plugging in for x, and then, of course, you have to be really careful with all of your steps. To check your answer usually is a lot more work than just doing the problem over. All right, so this means that 2/7 is the correct solution. So our answer is 2/7. We could put it in the solution set. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.